Welcome back. In today's session, I'm going to discuss with you about the reduce operator. Okay, so what is the use of this reduce operator? We can just see some examples and we can try to understand how this can be used in real time. Okay, so I'll provide you certain examples, like you can make use of that in your projects or in your if you have any requirements like such as this, you can make use in those kind of scenarios. So reduce operator, basically it is used in cases where you want to do a counter operation. Okay, if you want to find the sum of certain values inside a field in an internal table using some condition, you can make use of this operator. So this is very useful compared to if you want to find the subtotal. If you want to find the total of a particular column in an internal table, you can make use of this keyword. So this is very pretty easy to use this, but yeah, it will take you some time to, you know, understand this keyword and also the specific keywords that comes along with this reduce operator. So without wasting time, let's get started. All right. And if you have not subscribed to my channel, I would request you to, you know, subscribe to this channel for more videos and more updates like this. So this is a very important video is what I'll tell you, because this operator, not many would have actually used this in real case scenario. Like there are people who would have used this, but yeah, this is kind of unknown for few people. So let us explain this in detail and we'll try to understand and make use of this in your in your projects whenever you want this. Okay, so let's get started. So reduce is the keyword. Okay, and I'll write reduce I. Okay, so what I'm saying is reduce this expression inside this brackets. Okay, will get reduced to an integer type. I here stands for integer type. So I'm saying reduce the expression inside this brackets to an integer type, and then I'll store this in a variable. At runtime, this v1 here, v1 will be having the value of type integer. Okay, and whatever is being extracted from inside this bracket will be you will have it in v1. All right, so what do we write inside this? Suppose my first requirement, let me explain it to you. It would be to find the sum of first 10 numbers. Okay, so this is, if this is the requirement, how do I proceed with this reduce keyword or the reduce operator? So first of all, I will initialize. Okay, I'm just trying to explain to you what or how this is used and the basic examples I'm explaining. Later we will go to the internal table part, okay, which will be actually useful in your real time, but here I'm just trying to explain to you how it works. Okay, so I'm first initializing sum. I'll declare a variable called sum and I'll initialize it with value 0. Okay, so this is like providing default value to a variable. You do it in normal ABAP. Here I'm just initializing it for the sum operation. Okay, so basically here I will be adding all these numbers. 10. Okay, so the final sum should hold what? It will be 55. The sum of all these first 10 numbers would be 55. So the sum will finally contain 55, and this 55 will be stored in v1. Okay, so I have initialized sum as 0, and then I'll start an iteration. I'll start a loop kind of thing. So that is why we are using the for keyword. Okay, I'll say for I equal to 1. Okay, what is the first number? 1 is the first number. Okay, and how is the increment going to be? The increment is like for it's with 1, right? So each number gets added with 1, right? 1 plus 1 equal to 2, 2 plus 1 equal to 3. So then I'll write the keyword then I plus 1. Okay, first I'm declaring I, and then I'm incrementing it with 1. Then what? Until what? What is the last number? The last number would be 10. Okay, so it should continue till I is 10, right? So I'll then provide until I greater than 10. So when I becomes 11, this should stop processing. This is should stop computing the sum. Okay, now I'll have another keyword called next. I know it is a bit confusing if you're trying to do it for the first time because of the number of keywords which we are using here. Okay, you will get used to it. I mean, if you understand it in a simpler way, I think you can make use of it at any time, right? So I'll say next. So this is the place where exactly this computation is happening. So sum is being computed at this stage. I'll say sum plus I. Okay, so that means first sum would be 0 and then it will get added with 1. So sum in the first loop or the first iteration when I equal to 1, sum will be provided with 1, right? So in each loop pass, in each iteration, it will get added. So it will follow this logic of 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus, okay? And once it is 10, then it will come out of the loop. So finally, sum will have 55. Okay? Let me see what is the output. I'll say write V1. So finally, V1 should contain this value, computed value of 55. So like you can see here, 55 is the output. Okay, so this is pretty much straightforward, very simple, right? So it is a one-line logic, but yeah, you would need some time to understand these keywords, but once you come to know that, then you can do it very easily. Now, even if I don't specify this, then let me activate this, execute. Still, it will be 55. Why? Because by default, the increment will go by 1. Okay, so by default, even if you don't specify the then keyword, it will actually increment by 1 only. Suppose if you want increment by 2, okay, you can provide it like this. Or if you want a decrement, then you can provide it this. But otherwise, if your increment is going to be 1, then you don't need this then keyword. All right. So that is about this. This is a basic example where you would now understand the importance of this reduce operator, right? So now I will also provide. I will try to make a string. I'll try to reduce use the reduce operator for the string data type. Okay, so this is how what I'm trying to do. I'll remove all this and write once again. So I'll initialize a string literal. Okay, I'll put a back quote here. Okay, I'll say count up. Okay. So this is a string literal and I'm using a back quote here. Okay, so I'm initializing text equal to count up. Then I'll declare this the same loop here, I equal to 1, okay, until I greater than 10. I will say next text equal to text and I'm going to concatenate the I value. Okay, so for that I will also use the this operator. Okay, for actually I is an integer, right? So I'm just trying to make use of it as a string and then concatenating it and then I'll put it in text. So if I try to I'll just show you the output here, right? Let's say V2. Okay, so it should basically contain count up. Okay, it will basically be like this, count up, and it will have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, so this will be the kind of output which you'll be getting here. All right, so this will have the text also. So the finally the V2 will be reduced to a string. Okay, here in this case it is of type integer which I was reducing it to. So here I am initializing text as count up, right? I'm using a string literal, that is why I'm actually reducing it to a string. Okay, I'll check, activate this now, execute this. So you can see here it will be adding 1 in each of the increment. Okay, I'm incrementing it by 1, right? As I already told you, there is also an implicit I plus 1 happening here. Okay, because of which the increment is happening with 1. And finally, the value will be stored in text. Text will contain the final value with added this integer value of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, etc. I'll activate this. So I plus 1. So now in the next case, I'll do a countdown. I'll do a countdown here. Now you can clearly understand why this then is used. So I'll start with 10. Okay. I'll decrement by 1. I'll decrement it till it becomes 1. Okay. So it will go from 10 to 1. Okay. The reverse order of count up. Okay. Now I'll write V3 also. Activate. Execute. So you can see countdown. The reverse operation of count up is happening here. Alright. Why? Because I specified it as then I minus 1. Okay. So let me check I minus 2 then. Let us see what will happen. So you can see 10, 8, 6, 4, 2. So the next, in the next iteration, it will be 0. So by the time it will end out of the loop. Why? Because I specified I is less than 1, it should end. So now you can clearly understand why and when this then should be used, right? So that's it, the basic examples of using a reduce operator. So now I will actually make use of this reduce operator to understand how it is to be used inside an internal table. All right, for that, first I'll declare my internal table. I'll declare a structure of student, say name type char20. I'll say subject type char20. And maybe, what do I say? I'll put something like marks. And I'll end this ty underscore student. I'll declare I tab now. Maybe it underscore student type table of ty underscore student. I'm taking a basic, a simple example to make you understand this. So it student becomes an internal table of type ty student. And now I will use the value keyword. So if you have not watched my value operator session, I have a session on value operator, so I would strongly recommend that you go back, watch that video to understand this better. Okay, so I'll put a link somewhere on the screen. You can check that out and you can come back to this video and try to understand about reduce operator. So IT underscore student, I'll say value. I'll put a hash. Okay, because I've already declared it of type TY students, that's why I'm putting a hash here. And then I will provide, I'll try to generate the columns, the values inside the columns dynamically. So for that, I will actually say name equal to, no, I'll start a loop for I equal to 1. Okay. And I'll say until I greater than 10. Okay. I'll say name equal to student. I'll say ampersand I. Okay, so in each loop, in each of the loop pass, in each of the iteration, it will be added with 1, 2, 3, 4, student 1, student 2, student 3, up to student 10, it will become, all right. And subject, I'm going to give one subject only. I'll say physics or something. And then the marks, let it be I only. So it won't look nice to see these kind of marks for student, because it will be like 1, 2, 3, 4, but I just wanted to show you how to use this for summation purpose, for finding out the total of the total marks of a student. Okay, so that is the use case here. Display, I'll say it underscore student. Let us activate this and execute. So you can see student 1, student 2, everybody is having the subject as physics, and marks is like 1 to 10. Okay, so this is, yes, you can actually, if you have a requirement, something similar, like if you have an integer field, you can find the sum of the marks of the students, right? You can make use of that, this reduce operator. I'll just show you how you can do that. So for that, I'll say reduce. I want to reduce it to integer, right? So basically, mainly it will be reduce operator might be used with integer. Okay, I'm going to return it back to a variable, maybe v1. Okay, so what will be the loop? I'll initialize sum or total as 0 first, and then I'll write my for loop for I equal to 1 until I greater than 10. We don't write this, we should not write this, because it is an internal table. The approach is different. Okay, in the earlier cases we have written it like this, right? For I equal to 1 to until I greater than 10. But in this case, because it's an internal table, I am going to provide a work area. I'll say work area in IT underscore student. So in each loop pass, it will be like iteration. You know, an internal table consists of rows and columns, right? So in each of the, it's like a loop only. Okay, like loop at I tab into WA into work area. So this is something similar to that. Okay, so I'm saying for work area inside of an internal table, next sum total plus work area marks. Okay, I think it's pretty straightforward. I'm writing a loop here, like loop at, in normal ABAP you will find loop at WA into work area. Okay, so this is something similar to that. So instead of writing loop and all that, you can make use of this reduce operator to find the sum. Okay, so it's similar to this. And what is the field which I want to compute the sum for? It is the marks field. Okay, so in each of the loop, the sum gets added up and the final value will be stored in total. All right, and now I'll say write v1, or I will say write here and control D. I'll say display v1. I just want to show you what's happening here. Execute. So you can see sum of the first 10 numbers, like what we have seen before. So that's why I took this example, because you can understand what the total should be, what the sum of this field should be. Okay, sum of first 10 numbers, it should be like 55, right? So we have seen that earlier. So now comes the real requirement, where in if you want to filter out the marks based on some condition, what you can do is, I'll do one more thing. I'll append one more value. I will append a value. So this is explained in the previous session of on value operator. So I'll append one value. I'll say name equal to student 10. So student 10 is already there in the list, right? So the 10th row should be of student 10. Okay, so I'm saying name equal to student 10, subject equal to max. Okay, maybe I'll add a new entry here. That's why I'm doing this. And I'll say marks equal to 20 into itab, it underscore student. So I'm adding one more value here. Activate, execute. So you can see for student 10, there are now two entries, 10 and 20. So I want to compute the sum of 10 and 20 here based on student 10. How do I do that? I will here filter out before the next keyword is used. I'll filter out using the where condition, where I'll say name equal to student 10. Close the bracket. Okay. So I'm doing this. And so what will be the total? It will be 30, right? So it's 30. So it is adding 10 and 20 based on student 10. All right. So that's it, guys, for this session. If you have any concerns, please put it in the comment section. If you really like the video, I would recommend that you give a thumbs up for the video and share it with your friends if you would like to. And please do not forget to like, comment, and subscribe to my channel, as I always tell.